they would like to achieve from the visit to Bandung is information about the good governance, financial arrangement, decentralization, and revenue mobilization. And that's the introduction. I give it all to the mayor.
What's the main objective would you like to understand, yeah, which focus, so I can give more emphasis on that issue?
Thank you, Honorable Man, Mr. Lagwani Kamil, the Deputy Man, our friends from Bandung. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
So let me introduce myself. My name is Michael Owen. I'm the lead of the delegation. I am the principal secretary in the Ministry of Evolution and Planning. So with me, I have a delegation from Kenya. And I would like to introduce them. Then I will make a few remarks on the objective of this visit. And then I'll hand over to you, Johanna. So maybe we will do some self-introduction.
Special secretary in the office of the deputy president, responsible for intergovernmental budget and economic affairs council.
Good afternoon, my name is Elizabeth Olma. I work in the city department of evolution, together with the principal secretary in the policy advisory.
Good afternoon. My name is Judith Begule Atian. I work with the Intergovernmental Relations Technical Committee. This is a committee that works in between the two levels of government, the national government and the county governments. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Mamou Mahi. I work with the Ministry of Information and Planning, in the Cabinet Secretary's Office as a senior advisor.
Good afternoon. My name is Rose Vangiero. I work with the civil society institution called Center for Economic Governance. But it's a thing that we're partnering with the Ministry of Information in work.
Good afternoon. My name is Nelson Ochungo. Nelson Ochungo, I come from the KPI. I'm the Director of Revenue.
Good afternoon, my name is Martin Anyango. I work in the office of the Permanent Secretary, State Department of Revolution. I'm in charge of capacity building and technical assistance.
Good afternoon, my name is Alan Buke. I work in the office of the Principal Secretary as a personal assistant. Thank you.
Honorable Mayor, I want to take this opportunity first and foremost to thank you on behalf of my delegation to thank the government of Indonesia the way we have been given such a warm welcome. Since we came, we have enjoyed our stay here in this country. For myself and I think most of these people, this is the first time we are coming to Indonesia. Okay, so I think it is we have been received very well. I can say the Indonesian people, wonderful people, so they have received quite well. We have intermingled and interacted quite well. Again, we are here today at Bandung. Yeah, the objective of this meeting in Kenya, evolution started this is just 5 years ago when it started. So, as a country, as a ministry, we wanted to find out countries which we can learn from. And one of the first and foremost countries which we saw it was good for us to learn and have some experience is Indonesia. And that is why we are here today. So we are in our second phase because the election cycle in Kenya takes 5 years. So the first phase took place in 2013. The second phase took place this month. In the 8th of August, we are just for a general election where we were electing both the national office bearers and the county government. So we have two levels of government, two tiers. We have the national government and then the county government. So the...
How many counties?
We have a total of 47 counties in the whole country. We have a population of 45 million as a country. So it's much smaller than Indonesia. So we are like a fifth of Indonesia's population.
So that's basically the story for you to understand how powerful this autonomy. But again, if you elected, deceived by the politician who persuade the people, well, it's not good. This is what happened. From 500 leaders, berapa yang masuk APK itu? Pemimpin daerah? Banyak bisa.
Mungkin 123 sopan.
From 500 leaders, 120 went to jail for corruption. In the history since 2001, okay? So this is what happened. When you have given so much power, but you are no integrity, right? You are suddenly having a power to make decision, to whatever. Then that's what happened. So I'm sorry to say, yes, there is a bad side of democracy, which for you to learn also, not always the good side. Yeah. So we have more than 20% or so was bad apples, went to jail for corruption. Okay? So that's always the theory. Yeah. Some say that, oh, before the corruption is centralized, in the centralized government. Now the corruption is also decentralized, creating a small kings and queens in the region because there are so much power. So this is also the negative effects here. In 100% of affairs, there are six things that I cannot make decision fundamentally. Number one, defense. As a mayor, I cannot order the military on my command, cannot. Because military, they report it directly to the central government, okay? Even though I have military in the city, I cannot order. I just need to coordinate that. Security also, the police is not under my command, it's not under my payroll. The police is under the central government payroll. They report, the chief, city police chief, report to the provincial police chief, report to the national police chief. All I can do is asking politely to secure my city, but I cannot just pointing finger to, Number three is religion. I cannot make any policy to forbid or let any religious belief. Religion is handled directly by the central government. Number four is fiscal policy. I cannot freely creating a fiscal policy, borrowing money from the banks or creating municipal bonds, without the permission of central government. So they will be creating a very strict regulation on the fiscal monetary policy. Number five is judicial, so I cannot influence the judges, the district attorney, for example, whatever issues of judicial issues, I cannot have power to interfere or make decision. Number six is foreign policy, so I cannot go to Israel, for example, because Israel and Indonesia doesn't have any relationship. The city mayor of Bandung suddenly is in Israel, so I will be punished because of making error, for example. Because I believe advanced society is a happy society. Some cities are just spending just physical infrastructure. But no, in Bandung, we put budget to make people happy. Number one, knowledge and insight how in Indonesia, a very diverse nation and culture, united, move forward to a country that are getting better. Indonesia grow 5% of economy, my city grow highest 7.8%. So happiness index is very high, so many good news. But yes, I have problem in city transportation because I don't have money to build MRT, it's very expensive, yeah. But my only problem is now is road transportation.
And also, we welcome you people to come to Kenya so that we can
have exchange
visits and have a taste of our hospitality, the way we have had a taste of yours. So with those few remarks, let me now allow my colleagues, if you have some questions, some compliments, now this is the right time you can be.
You actually have based your development on a philosophy, the philosophy of happiness, and you are focused on it, and everything you have done has actually been to make sure that the citizens of Bandung are happy. And these are really very impressive, and I don't think they're very expensive. But I think you have worked very well with the humanity principle. Yeah. You have been touching your human beings and how you make them happy. I think I also noticed that actually when you came to the city, I remember telling my colleague that I think I prefer Bandung to Jakarta. You know, it looks nicer and yeah, that was my impression that Bandung somehow had a character. Yeah. But also, I just want to say that I also noticed that schools like have a three sort of tier, you know, system. There's the national government, then there's the provincial, and then there's the city.
Right.
Yeah, where there's the mayor. And you say that, you know, this system started in 2001.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I probably want to believe that there are functions that therefore belong to the different levels of the government. There are things that you said, there are six that are only just belonging to the national government, and then there are maybe others that just belong to the provincial government, and then others that, you know, only the city can carry out.
Yeah. The selection number one, we call it the civil servant. Yeah. Selected by national government, we just give the people. So we don't have local selection. For example, yeah, Mr. Mayor, I want to work in your office to become the city government official. You have to be selected through the competition in national level.
Is that running?
What's the right thing?
Masai.
Oh, Masai.
Kenyan Masai. This guy jumped very high up and down, so when you come to Kenya, be prepared to jump up and down. And they can kill a lion.
Kill a lion.
So this is the Kenyan flag.
In my culture, we have value the head, you know, as the sacred organ. So we have in our culture to wear this headscarf, and we have 21 ways of forming the meeting. It's a symbol of something, it's a message. This this meeting symbolized for the king. So if you come to Bandung, wear this, and you become the honorable person in Bandung.